Yeah, here we have a Ballet 20-inch variable speed drill press. This has an automatic downfeed and a coolant system. There's a coolant pump there. Just going to go over here to the back of the control panel to show you. You got a variable speed control, delta. All your contactors, your fuses, your inverter, and your transformer. I'm going to close this up. The latch isn't operational right here, so that needs to be replaced. We'll just turn the unit on. Okay, we'll go to the front here. And we're going to first start off with the tapping mode here. That's in the reverse mode. There's a shut off, you pull out your e-stop, you turn the machine on, there's a green button that lights up. Alright, we'll hit the reverse button here, as you can see. It is now in reverse. It does have a 3-speed automatic down feed. You put the, when you're tapping, you put it in the zero position right here. Okay. Has a work light. The work light operates fine. Okay, so now we're going to stop the machine. We're going to switch it over to the drilling mode here. And we're going to turn the variable speed all the way down. Okay, turn it back on. Now it's at about 66 RPM, 65, 66. And as you turn the knob, this is currently on the low speeds. Okay, that's the highest on the low speeds there. Okay, let's stop that. What we'll do is we'll shift it over to this mode right here. That's going to be your downfeed mode. All right, again, we'll go start. Put it on the highest right there. Switch it over to 02. As you can see, you have your automatic downfeed. Now, this downfeed hand wheel took a hit. It still operates, but it is wobbling. Okay? That may be able to, you might be able to straighten that out, but it doesn't really interfere with the operation of the machine here. So, as you can see, the downfeed is operating now. Turn that off. We'll switch it to a higher speed. So you just switch that over there to the rabbit. Get the turtle and the rabbit. Now we'll fire it up again. Much higher rate, and as it bottoms out, automatically comes back up. You can also put this in manual mode, do your drilling that way if you want. So again, pull back on the handles here. Slow down. That's the highest speed. That's on the high gear setting right here. Turn it down a little bit. That's 1200 RPM. As it goes down the bottom again, comes back up. This is all spring loaded in here. Now the coolant pump operates. Tested that. That operates fine. It only operates when the machine is on. The coolant, all the coolant tube and some of the accessories for the coolant feed here, they're not included. I don't know what happened to those. Also, we have a guard here. The bracket broke off from here. Okay, to the back side of this. So this piece is going to definitely need to be replaced. The limit switch does operate, however, it was got pulled out of the thing there, and we had to bypass it to get the machine running. So, and this operates as a safety switch when you pull back the guard. has a dent right here. It doesn't affect the control panel at all, but it is on this top plate here. Okay, and also, like I said, we have a 3-speed down feed here. The rest of the machine is in really great condition. All the electrical and most of the mechanical functions operate very nicely on here. So, and we thank you for looking at our product.